All right, time to get in shape. Ready, watch.
You ran 1.3 miles and burned 300 calories.
Wow. Here we go again. That's gotta be twice as far than yesterday.
You ran 1.2 miles and burned 205 calories.
What? That makes no sense. Okay, here we go.
You ran 18.4 miles and burned negative 204 calories.
You stupid piece of...
Today, we're going to talk about a little fitness device that's been all the rage in recent years, thanks in no small part to the heavy advertising of smartwatches being a reliable fitness tracker. And tracking one of the fitness metrics that has eluded consumer capabilities until now is arguably its most appealing feature, and that is, of course, tracking your calories burned. But have you wondered exactly how these little gadgets work? The concept that a simple wristwatch can do so much can be quite mind-boggling when you consider that research-grade methods of tracking calories involves equipping a CO2 respirator or confining people in melancholic metabolic chambers that measure every breath you take, every move you make. And even then, they are subject to some degrees of error. Obviously, a wristwatch doesn't measure the same things as a mask or a chamber, so it requires something else completely, and one of which comes from that flashy green light on the underside of your watch. We won't get into too much detail as to how it works, but by emitting green light, the watch's optical PBG sensor tracks blood circulation of your wrist, which outputs data to measure a little thing called your heart rate. Using your heart rate along with your age, height, and weight, we can determine a close estimate of one's VO2. Or oxygen consumption, which itself can be used as an estimate in calculating calorie expenditure. Now, the use of heart rate and VO2 to calculate calorie estimates is nothing new, but the key word here is estimates, and a loose one at that. And it's assuming that the heart rate monitoring your watch is accurate as well, which in one case study has shown that heart rate measurements can vary greatly simply by adjusting the tightness of the wristband. So you have an equation that's only a loose estimate of calorie expenditure, and you also have a variable in that equation, heart rate, that might not be accurately measured. Not the best look so far. However, smartwatch manufacturers stated that their data collection involves more than just heart rate and user information. Some boast a complex secret proprietary software, and recently some equipped with accelerometers even claim to measure every single movement you make, all conveniently through a device that can also read your notifications. This lack of software disclosure, however, creates a barrier for researchers to understand how the devices truly work. We don't know exactly what's being measured or whether the formula they're using is reliable. Now, overall, there's nothing exactly wrong with getting an estimate if the estimate itself is not that far off from the actual numbers. Even the nutrition information on food packaging are estimates, which can vary based on how the food is processed. But for food labels, they're widely considered as reliable enough, thanks to rigorous disclosed testing. For fitness trackers, though, can we say the same thing? Are they good enough? Again, what we already know, the variability of heart rate data, an undoubtedly huge part of the equation, no matter what fancy proprietary software the watch might have, can itself lead to significant differences in estimates. Just knowing that should be reasonable enough to doubt its reliability. But let's look a bit further in the studies. A 2017 study tested multiple smartwatches available from companies like Garmin, Fitbit, and Apple. What they found was pretty interesting. Along with calories, they also compared data for steps and distance traveled between the devices. What they noticed was that none of the devices were ever in agreement for any measured outcome, with the Apple Watch reporting as much as 20% more steps and 40% more distance traveled compared to the other watches. In terms of calories, at times there was as much as a 35% difference in calories measured between an Apple Watch and Fitbit Flex. So just comparing one device to another, there can be very different readouts, which no doubt again makes you wonder exactly how accurate they are. But the big test is comparing these fitness watches to tried and true gold standard measurement tools. In 2019, researchers set out to do just that. In this study, researchers pit 5 different fitness watches against a metabolic calorimetry chamber and measured estimated physical activity calorie expenditure. Compared to the chamber, 4 of the 5 watches reported fewer calories burned, with one reporting roughly 500 physical activity calories fewer than the metabolic chamber. The remaining watch overreported by roughly 110 calories. And although using a metabolic ward is great in terms of testing accuracy, we obviously don't live in huge gas measuring boxes, so the researchers also also performed a 15-day free living trial. The watches were compared to another research-grade tool called doubly labeled water, a special type of water that, when administered, can measure a subject's daily metabolic rates during free living conditions. In this trial, we also see similar underreporting across the devices, this time in all five of them, with the greatest offender underreporting by about 700 calories per day. Those are some pretty huge discrepancies, needless to say. Now, in fairness, this study was in 2019, and it is likely that manufacturers made some improvements to their top secret software since then. Although another 2022 study did find underreporting issues as well, notably in underreporting heart rate. And the 2019 study didn't include one of the more popular watches, the Apple Watch. Whether Apple or anyone else has the technology to surpass the competition, however, remains to be seen. But that's what we see in the research so far, and based on what we know, are smartwatches and other similar devices accurate calorie estimators? Probably not, but it is interesting that most of the data suggests an underreporting of activity and calories rather than overreporting. I personally thought it would be the opposite. This might have to do with the limited ability to track specific exercises, especially intense exercises that don't require much arm movement like cycling, or exercises that don't require much distance traveled like lifting weights. Whatever the case, it's clear that in terms of specifically tracking calories, the tech isn't there just yet. It still will largely boil down to you figuring out not how many calories you're burning, but rather how much you're eating that will play the ultimate role in your weight-changing goals. Still, what's great about fitness watches is that it is consistent in tracking trends and changes. Even though the numbers aren't entirely accurate, if the watch can detect an upward trend in calories burned by you increasing exercise, then that's still useful data. It might even mean quite a lot if seeing these trends inspire you to maintain a more active and healthy lifestyle. In fact, a 2022 survey in the ICSAD Journal found that only 20% of respondents were exercising for more than 4 days a week before wearing a fitness watch, but that number went up to 34% after. Another limited review further discovered that sedentary individuals were more likely to increase physical activity when using a wearable fitness tracker. And even in terms of health, in one case study, a smartwatch detected an irregular change in a woman's resting heart rate, which led to her getting diagnosed and treated for a serious inflammation condition of her blood vessels. These other health and fitness impacts can be extremely useful to the point that I would definitely suggest if you can get a fitness watch, then you should. Just understand its pros and cons and try not to adjust it too often when you're wearing it to not throw off the sensor too much. I've personally been wearing one for the past 3 years, apparently burned about 85 calories since then. Awesome. But that's what we know about smartwatches and calorie tracking so far. Not great, but not exactly junk, and it's still great for many other cool fitness stuffs. If you already have one, keep using it. And if you're thinking about getting one, it gets a thumbs up in my book. Oh, burned about 5,021 calories while recording this video. Sounds about right. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a smarty thumbs up and share it with your watch-loving friends. Subscribe for more. Oh, and follow me on Instagram, especially if you like more quick and useful fitness information. I'll be posting more often there soon. As always, thank you for watching and get your calorimetric protein.